Okay, welcome all. Welcome to the lecture number 22. In this lecture, we are going to start with the chapter number 5, that's called as the menus, notification and the action bar. For the today's lecture, we'll actually see how to program with the menus in the Android application development. So let's start. So the first thing is, what is Android menus? With respect to the Android app development. It's just like to the menus that you have in your website. Okay. But the place where the menus are actually displayed, that's different for the Android application. So let's see. So in Android, the menu is the important UI part, which provides some of the common functionality to the user. Now, whatever the functionalities which are provided to the user are unique across the, or we can say are the same across the entire app. Okay. So most of the times you might have used the Gmail app. Okay. Then there is a menu at the top right corner. Okay. Where you can either compose the mail, where you can delete the mail, or where you can move the mail from inbox to archive or inbox to trash. Okay. So such kind of applications which are global to your such kind of menus which are global to your app are displayed under the menus. So how we can create the menus in Android application? So in order to create the menus in Android application, we have to write a separate XML file which consists of the description about the menu. Okay. So every menu has three things associated with it. The first thing for every menu that we should provide is the ID of that menu. So every menu is identified by the unique identifier that's basically called as the ID. Now this particular ID is used internally by the Android system just to identify which particular menu item is selected by the user. Now the second thing or the second most important thing with respect to any menu item is that's nothing but the title. Okay. So every menu item has a title which is displayed on your screen. Okay. Now this particular title is used to identify that particular menu item. Okay. By the user. Okay. So just remember, ID is important because based on the ID, the system is identifying the menu item, and title is also important because based on the title, the user is going to identify that particular. Okay. So title and ID, these are the two most important things. And the third thing, which can be optional. That is nothing but the icon. Okay. So for any menu item, if you want to display the icon, you can do that also. Okay. But the thing is that all the things has to be defined inside the XML file. So let's see how we can create the XML file for the menu. Now, for creating the XML file for the any menu that we want to create, there is a standard format given by the Android standards. Okay. In every XML file which defines the menu, we have to define the menu with the help of menu attribute. Now we can create the sub items with the item attribute, okay, which defines each menu item in that particular respective menu. Okay, now where we should create that particular menu file, that should be created inside the project directory, inside the resource folder, and inside of the source folder, we have to create a new folder that's called as a menu. So let's see how we can create this resource directory. So can you see my Android Studio window? Just reply in the chat box. Okay. So we'll create a new Android Studio project just to see how we can create the menus for my Android application. So we'll choose an empty activity. Then click on next. So I'll name this particular application as menu demo and click on finish. So as you can see, it's building the project. So gradually will take some time in order to build our project by generating the files. So here you can see on the left side window, we have three folders, that's the manifest, then the Java and the resources. Okay. Now since menu is a XML file or resource XML file, what we have to do is we have to create our menu inside the resource file, inside the resource folder. So we'll click on the resource folder and we'll choose new. Okay, now first we need to add the resource directory. Okay, so we'll click on the Android resource directory. Now you can see there are the various types of the resource directory that I can have inside the resource folder. Okay, so out of these choices, I have to choose the resource type as menu. So here you can see the resource type I have selected as a menu. And whenever I choose the resource type as menu, it will automatically modify the name of the directory as menu. Okay. So let's choose it and click on OK. Now, as you can see, as soon as I click on the OK, one directory is created here with the name menu. Okay. So whatever our additional menu items are there, we need to add it inside this particular directory. Okay. So just we are going to right click on this directory that we have created, and now we have to add the resource file inside the resource directory. So we'll just right click on new, and we'll choose menu resource file. Okay. Now we have to give the file name for the menu resource file. Okay. Now remember, whenever you are giving the name, all the letters should be in the small case. Okay. So I'll write this as test menu. So I'll name it as test menu. And then we'll click on OK. Now, once you give the file name as test menu, and once you click on the OK, you can see one file is created. That's pastemenu.xml. Now this is the important thing. Okay, so for every menu XML file, we should have the root element. Okay, that's called as a menu. Okay, so this is the most important element. Now for every menu, we have to add every menu item by using the item element. So this is how we can add it. Now, as I said, every menu item has two important attributes. One is the ID and another is the title. So we'll choose the attribute ID first of all. Now, in order to generate a new ID, we have to use the prefix @+ID. Okay. Now, plus here denotes we have to create a new ID. Now, if you want to refer the existing ID, you can simply write @ID. But if you want to create a new ID, you should write @+ID. Now, since we are creating a new item, we'll write @+ID. Now, you can choose any ID as per your choice. So I'll call it as a menu one, or I'll call it as menu item one. Now we'll try to complete this menu item or close this menu item attribute. Now you can see, even if I close this, it will give us an error. The reason behind this is we said we have two compulsory attributes for every menu item, that is ID and the title. And here we have given only one attribute, that's basically the ID. Okay, so unless and until we give the title attribute also, okay, our program will not compile. So we'll give the title attribute. So let's call android:title is equal to. Now this particular title must be in form of the pure string. Now you can define the string here. So what name we should give here? So let's call it as about us, or we'll simply call it as menu item one. So now you can see, since I have given both the required attributes, the error is now disappearing. Okay, so let's create a few such items. So I'll simply copy this and I'll paste it below. Okay, now you can see there are four item elements which shows four different menu items. Now for the duplicate item elements with the duplicate IDs, it will show the error. So what we need to have here is we need to keep all the ID elements unique. So I'll call it as menu item 3 and menu item 4. I'll also change the title in this case. So this is menu item 2, this is menu item 3, and this is menu item 4. Okay. Now here you can see I have created a menu XML. Which is starting with the root tag or the parent tag menu, and which consists of four different menu items. Each is defined with the corresponding element called as a item. Okay, so here we have our menu XML ready. Okay, so if you want to see, you can see I have given the sample menu XML file here. Okay, so for every new ID that I want to create, I have to add @+ID. Okay, optionally you can add the icon also. The most important thing is for the icon, you have to put your icon files inside the drawable directory. Okay, so for current example, we'll simply skip the icons. Okay, so this is how we can create the menu with the submenu. Okay, we'll see next example for creating the submenu. But before that, let's have a look at which are the different kinds of menu that we have in the Android. Okay, for example, if you are creating a website, for a website, you have a different types of menu. Okay, you have a navbar, which is at the top. Then you also have this sidebar, okay, which is different for each page. Okay, so what we can say, for a website, the navbar is global. Okay, that is applied for all the pages for your website. Okay, and sidebar can be different for every page. Okay, in the Android application development also, we have the same concept, but the names of menu are different. Okay, the menu which is global for your entire app is called as the options menu, while the menu which is different for each of the activity is basically called as the context menu. So always remember, options menu is global, it is applied throughout your entire app, and context menu can change its appearance or change its content as per your activities. Okay, so let's see how we can create the options menu first of all. Okay, as you can see, the option menu is basically shown on the app bar. Okay, so whatever I said, whenever you go to the Gmail app, okay, whatever the menu items you see on the top right corner is called as the options menu. Okay, now let me run this particular app, okay, just by writing the menu XML file, and let's see what happens. If you have created the menu.xml file, you can also see its design by clicking on the split icon which is given here. So with the help of split icon, you can see the actual XML file and how your menu will look in your UI component. Let me unlock the device. So what's the problem? Yeah. Now you can see the app is built, but the menu is not visible here. The menu is not visible here. So this is the most important thing that you have to remember. Just by defining the menu inside the menu.xml will not make your menu visible in your UI component. Okay, in order to do that, you have to override a method, and that method is actually used to identify what kind of menu that we are going to create. Whether the menu that we are going to create is the options menu, or the menu that we are going to create is the context menu. Okay, that will be dependent on the type of method that we are going to override. Okay, so currently I have to define a menu, okay, which is global for my entire app. So I want to define the option menu. Okay, so if you want to do that, you have to override one method. Okay, so let me write the method name here. So that method is called as on create options menu. Okay, the method is called as on create options menu. Okay, so just hit the enter by accepting the suggestion. Now, as you can see here, the onCreateOptions menu is the method which takes one parameter of type menu. Okay. Now, the thing is, whatever this particular object is there, I need to initialize the object by filling all the components that we have defined inside the menu.xml. Okay. So, let's see how we can do that. Now, can anybody answer me how we were generating the UI component from the XML file? Yeah, we have done it before also. Anybody remember that, for which particular thing we have generated the component from the XML file? That's for the dialog. Okay, so what we were doing is, we were defining certain components inside the XML file. Okay, then we were taking the XML components and filling that XML components inside a UI component. Okay, along with the dialog, we did one more thing. Anybody remember that? Okay, anyone remembers we created the custom list. We created the custom list. I don't know whether I have shown you the demo of custom list or not. Custom list. So custom list is just like the contacts list that you have in your mobile. So what we did is basically we created such kind of list where at the left side you have the icons and at the right side you have the corresponding text. Okay. Yeah, we showed it with the spinner. So how we did that? In order to pin the XML components inside the UI components, we use something that's called as the inflator class. Okay. Now, the general inflator class is for the standard dialogues. For creating the menus from the menu.xml file, what we have is something called as the menu inflator. Okay. So this class we require here. The class is called as the menu inflator. So what is the job of the menu inflator? It does a very simple job. It reads each menu item from the menu.xml and pins that particular item inside your UI component. Okay, so let's create the object of the class. So class name space object, so menu inflator. I'll call this object as inflator. So menu inflator is equal to new menu inflator. Okay. Now as you can see, this particular constructor requires one parameter of type context. Okay. Now the context means on which particular component I'm supposed to create this particular menu. Okay. Now since I want to create this menu for the entire application. Okay, because this is an optional menu, so I can write here as get application context. Okay, so when I give you here the application context, I can say that this particular menu will be created for my entire app. Okay, so we created the inflator object of type menu inflator, and we passed the parameter. Okay, which is nothing but the context of the application. Okay, now once we create the inflator, we have to inflate the XML file inside the UI component. Now, how to do that? We'll be using the inflator object here, inflator dot, and you can see there is one method available here, and the method is called as inflate. Okay, so in order to inflate the XML file into the UI component, we have to use the inflate method of the menu inflator class. Okay, so inflator dot inflate, and now if you see carefully, the inflate method takes two parameters. The first parameter is the resource ID of the menu, and the second parameter is the menu object. Okay, so what is the resource ID of the menu? So we know our resources can be referred with the help of R dot. Okay, so R is basically a class. So R dot, now since it is a menu, I should write R dot menu, which is a static field inside the R class. Then R dot menu dot, and we are supposed to give the ID of our menu. Okay. Now, as I said, the title is used by the user to identify that particular menu or the menu item, and internally it uses the ID. Okay. So you can see here, it has generated one integer ID for the menu that we have created. Okay, so we'll select that particular ID. So inflator dot inflate r dot menu dot test menu. Okay, so this is our first parameter. Now the second parameter is the actual UI component inside we have to inflate our XML item. Okay, now we can see here options menu on create options menu method takes one parameter by default, which is of type menu, and it returns that menu. Okay, So I need to inflate all my XML items inside this argument. So I'll simply pass this as a second parameter. Okay. So just we have inflated our menu from the XML file. Now let's try to run our app and see what happens. So I'll click on execute. So it will apply the changes and it will launch the app. Now, as you can see, once we inflate the menu by writing or by overriding onCreateOptions menu method, you can see there are three dots appearing in the top right corner. Okay. Now let's click on these three dots and see. Okay. Now, as you can click on these three dots, you can see four menu items are displayed to me. That's menu item 1, menu item 2, and menu item 3, and menu item 4. Okay. So this is how we can generate the options menu in our Android app. Okay. Now let's go back to the slides. Okay. And we'll see how to create the submenu. Okay. Now, as you can see here, in order to create the submenu, I have to define the additional menu tag, which is the child of the item tag. Okay. So for example, let's consider in this menu item 2, I have three sub items. Let's say item 2.1, 2.2, and 2.3. Okay. So we have to create this sub menu under the menu item 2. Okay. So how we can create that? So for that, I'll go to the XML of this. Okay. And we have to navigate to the item which represents the menu item. So this is the item. Okay. Now between the opening and closing tag of menu item 2, I have to create the submenu. Now we know the menu can be created with the root tag menu. So I need to give the root tag menu under the item tag in which I have to create the submenu. Now as you can see, as soon as I add this menu tag here, one caret icon is shown here under the menu item 2. Now let's add the sub items. Okay, so let's say item ID is equal to @+ID, menu item 2.1. Okay, so this is nothing but first item inside the menu item 2. Okay, and we'll give the title as sub item 2.1. And we'll simply copy this item tag and we'll paste it below. So we have created three sub items. Okay. Now ID of each sub item should be unique. So we'll simply modify the ID like this. Also we'll modify the title. So we'll call it as sub menu item 2.2 and sub menu item 3.3. Now this is how we can create the submenu. Now let's try to execute it and see what happens. Yeah, so we'll click on these three dots available in the top right corner. And as you can see, a caret icon is shown here in the menu item 2. If I click on this icon, you can see the sub items are displayed and the title given to this particular sub item menu as a menu item 2. Okay, so this is how these sub menu items are displayed. Okay, so till now, if you have any doubt, please ask. We have just seen how to create the menu UI component for the options menu. Okay. So the important thing that you have to remember is options menu is global for your entire application. So for all the activities, the same options menu will be visible. Can we write on click method in Submino. Yes, we can write the on click method in Submino. That is basically the event handling on the menu that we are going to see. For this particular session, we are just going to see how we can generate the different types of menus. Okay, if time is there, we'll also see how to handle the events on the menu. Okay, so this is how we can create the options menu. If you have any doubts in the options menu, you can ask. Otherwise, we'll proceed to the context menu. Okay, we'll see the event handling. First, let's see how we can create the context menu. So as you can see here, the context menu is basically a floating menu which appears on every activity. Okay, so the context menu can be different for a different activity. Okay, now the context menu is basically bound to the component which is present on the activity. So what we can say, options menu is bound to your application, while the context menu is bound to any of the UI component that you have on your activity. Now, let's say on this particular activity, we have the button and we have to create the context menu for that button. Okay, so let's see how we can create it. I'll choose the mode as the split mode, so you can see both the code as well as the design. Okay. Now, as you can see, the layout is the constraint layout here, and by default, one text view is available. So what I'll do here is I'll change this particular text view to the button. Okay. So it will display the button at the center of the activity. Now what I can say is this button is the property of the activity. So I can say this button will be available for only this activity, and I want to create the context menu which has to be registered with this button. Okay, so in order to do that, the component with which we are going to register the context menu need to have an ID. So I'll just give the ID to this button. So we'll call @plus ID and we'll give the ID as BTN. BTN. Okay, now we have to refer this particular button inside our Java file. In order to refer the XML component inside a Java component, we have to create the object of class button. So let's call button BTN, or let's call button B only. And then we can map the XML component in my object as B is equal to find view by ID R dot ID dot and the ID we created with the name BTN. Now here you can see the integer ID that Android system has created internally for our UI component. Yeah, so here we have created a button and we have mapped it from the XML to the Java object. Okay, now we have to create a separate context menu for this button. Okay, now what we'll do, we'll add one more menu in this case. We'll just right click on the current menu directory, we'll click on new, and we'll add a new menu resource file. Okay, now this time we'll call it as CTX menu. Okay, now all the letters should be small caps. So I'll call it as CTX menu and click on OK. Okay. Now the CTX menu is basically the context menu. Obviously, you can give any name to it. Now let's create the menu items quickly. Let's say item ID as M1 and title as C menu 1. Okay, now let's create one more item. I call it as M2 and M3, and this will have a title as C menu 2 and C menu 3. Okay. Now, as you can see, the preview is shown here. Okay, as an option menu, but this is just for our reference. The menu is not actually created when we add it inside the XML file, but they are created when we override the corresponding method. Okay, now let's run it and see whether the context menu is displayed here or not. So let me check what's the problem here. So here is the problem. While giving the ID, I need to add the prefix either to the sign in. If you don't add it, your program will not compile. Let's recompile it and see what difference it makes. You can see here the app is now running. Now, if I click on the top right, the option menu is visible. Okay, now if I click on the button, it will handle the on click action on that. If I long press the button, okay, nothing is happening. The reason behind this is we have just created the XML file for the context menu. In order to create the UI component for the context menu, I need to override a method again. Okay, now this time the method is called as on create context menu. So this is the method on create context menu. Okay, now one thing you have to remember is for on create options menu, the return type is boolean, and for on create context menu, the return type is word. Okay, now you can see here on create context menu takes three parameters. The first parameter is the actual menu that you want to display. The second parameter is view. Okay, what we said is context menu can be attached with any of the UI component on your activity. So reference of that UI component is passed as a second parameter here. And the third is the context menu info. So if you want to add some additional information to your menu, you can add it here. Okay. So let me create the menu UI component by inflating it. So the rest of the methodology is same. So I can say menu inflator. Inflator is equal to new menu inflator. And this time I have to pass the context of the current activity. So I can say main activity dot this. Okay. Now see the difference here. For the options menu, I have passed the reference of, or I have passed the context of the entire application by calling the get application context method. For the context menu, since it should be attached with the activity only, I have passed the reference of the current activity with the help of activity class name dot this. Okay, so what I have written here, main activity dot this. Okay. Now, once we do that, we have to inflate our menu. So, inflator dot inflate. Okay. Now, this time the XML file. Let me check it. What's the name of that? Okay. So, this time the name of the XML file is CTX menu. So, R dot menu dot CTX menu. This is the first parameter, and the second parameter is the name of the UI component. Now you can see it has the name as menu itself. So pass this as a second parameter. Okay. Now let's try to compile it and run it again and see whether we can see the context menu. Okay. So here we are seeing the option menu. Okay. And there is no other option available which will show me the context menu.
I think I closed the app. Let me relaunch it.
So you can see, even if I long click the button, you can see the context menu is not available. Okay. Now the reason behind this is very simple. I have created the context menu only, but I haven't attached this particular menu with any UI component. Okay. Now how to attach it? You have to attach it inside onCreate method. Okay. So here you have created the button. And here you have the onCreate method. So as soon as your app instance is created, onCreate method is launched, that we know. And as soon as the onCreate method is launched or called, we have to attach the context menu with the button. Okay. Now how to do that? For that, you have to call a method. And the method is called as a register for the context menu. Okay. So this is the method. Register for the context menu. Okay, so as you can see, register for context menu takes one parameter of type view. Okay, now in this case, I want to attach the context menu. I want to attach the context menu with the button. So I'll pass the object B as a parameter. Okay, now let's try to recompile it and see the changes. So if I click on the top right corner, we can see the options menu. Here we can see the sub menus. Okay. If I click on the button, it will handle the click action. And if I long click the button, you can see the context menu is now appearing. Okay. You can see the context menu is now visible. Okay. So this is what the context menu is. You can attach this particular menu with any of the UI element available on the activity inside your Android app. Okay. Also, if you want to set the title, you can set it here. So let me show you how you can set the title. So the menu item is called as a menu dot. You can call the method here. The method is called as set header title. Okay. So I'll call, so what name you can give here? I'll call it as test menu. So test menu. Now let's recompile the app and see. So if I long press the button now, you can see the title is visible here. Okay. So for a context menu, you can also provide the title of the menu. Okay. So this is how you can generate this particular two types of menus. One is the option menu and another is the context menu. Okay. So you can have a separate context menu for each of the UI component. So please ask if you have any doubt in this. Yeah, now we will see how to handle the events for each of the menu item. Okay, so in order to see the event handling on the menu, we'll remove the unnecessary code. Okay, so we'll remove this particular button and the context menu code. Okay, just to make our program look simple. So I'll remove this method overriding. And also I'll change the menu layout. Okay, so we'll do a very simple implementation. So let's create three menus with the name RGB, okay, which denotes three different colors. That's a red, blue, and green. And with selection of any item, we'll select the background color of our app. So let's call this particular menu item as R. The title will provide here as red. Then let's create one more item We'll call it as G, and the title is green. Okay, so we have the two menu items only for the options menu. Now we'll go to the main activity. Now the rest of the code will remain the same. Now we just have to add the code for the event handler. Okay, so we have to override one method for this, and that is called as on options item selector. Okay, as you can see, for event handling you have to override one method, that's called as the on options item selector. Okay, now this particular method takes one argument, and that is nothing but the main item. That's nothing but the main item. So what we want to do here is, if user selects any of the menu item, we want to change the background color of our app. So for that, we have to give the ID to the background color. So let's call it as ID, Android plus ID, I'll call it as BG. Okay, which says it's a background. And we'll map this particular BG ID in our Java class. So I can say view B, and B is equal to B is equal to find view by ID R dot ID dot BG. Okay, now if user clicks on the menu item with the title red, the background color has to be changed to the red color. Okay, so we can do that. Now you can see, whenever user will click on any menu item, it will be passed as a reference to this particular method called as on options item selected. So in order to identify which menu item is selected, we can compare ID of both. We can compare the ID of both. So I can say the menu item with text red has the ID as R. So how we can compare it here? So I can say, if item dot, the method is called as get ID, get item ID equals to, we can choose the ID for the menu item, so R dot ID dot R, then we have to select the background color as well. So we can say V dot set background as color dot red. So color dot red. Okay. If item dot get item ID equals R dot ID dot G, that's a green, I can say V dot set background color as color dot clean. That's it. Okay. Now let's try to compile the code and see what output we get. Now here you can see two options are visible in my options menu. One is red and another is green. If I click on red, you can see the app background is changed to red. If I click on green, the app background is changed to green. So this is how we can basically create the options menu and the context menu for our app. And in order to handle the events, we have to override just one method. That method is called as on options item selector. Okay. Now there is one homework for you. Okay. I'll give you one hint. You have to raise them in doubt. How can we set this menu to the left side? Yeah, we can set this particular menu to the left side by changing the RTL layout. Okay, that we can cover in case of the actions bar. Okay, so you can see the name of the chapter is menus notifications and the actions bar. So when we look at the actions bar, we can see how to change the layout for the menus. Okay. So we have that point in our chapter where the BG is defined. What BG, what we are talking about? Where the BG is defined. BG is defined inside this activity main.xml. Okay. So what I did is whatever the parent layout is there, you can see here. There is a constraint layout which is acting as a parent for our activity. Okay. I have just given ID to this particular ID to this particular component. Okay. And what ID I have given here? BG. Okay. And I am just referring this particular BG inside my main activity.java here. Okay. So BG is nothing but the ID given to the entire constraint layout, which represents the background of my activity. Okay. The background color is limited to only that activity or whole app. Okay. The background color change is only limited to that particular activity. Okay. You can see, Kaushik, here, the constraint layout that I have defined here is inside the main activity.xml. So I can say whatever the constraint layout I have defined is just limited for this main activity only. Okay. So whenever I'm changing the color, it will change the color of the constraint layout, which is defined under the main activity.xml. And since the main activity.xml is attached to the main activity.java file only, I can say it will only change the color for that only activity, for that activity only. Okay. Is it clear, Kaushik? Kaushik, is it clear? Okay. How can we change the background color of whole app? This is not possible. This is not possible. In that case, you have to change the theme. Okay. In that case, you have to change the theme. So where this things is, where this particular theme is available is, if you go inside the values, okay, there is something called as the style.xml. Okay. Or there is something called as the colors.xml. Okay, so if you want to change the color, which is global to your app, you can define it inside your colors.xml. But as long as the background color of every activity is concerned, we have to change it in the respective XML file only. Okay, now there is a homework for you. Okay, so already I'll give one hint. So the homework is text below. Okay. For any of the UI component, you can take a button also. And now the thing is, you have to handle the on-click events on the context menu. Now the hint is, for the context menu event handling, you have to override the method, and the method is called as onCreateContextMenu. Okay, so what's the hint? You have to provide the on-click event handling for the context menu. And for that, you have to override the onCreateContextMenu method. Now see carefully, this method takes three arguments, context menu, then the actual view, and the menu info. Okay, now based on this information, you have to provide the event handling on the context menu. Okay, so this is your homework for today. So I'll be asking the questions about this particular homework in the next lecture. So I think that's it for today's lecture. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the chat box. Still there are 5 minutes. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the chat box. Otherwise, simply write no inside the chat box so we can end our lecture. If we create another activity, does menu appear there also, or we have to override onCreate option? Yeah, we have to override the onCreate option. Okay, what they say here is options menu is global to your app, means where they are displayed. They are displayed on your action bar, or you can say they are displayed on your title bar. Okay, and context menu are only visible on your activities. They are visible on your working area of activity. Okay, so I think if there are no doubts, we can end our lecture here. So still we have 5 minutes. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the chat box, or just type no in the chat box so we can end the lecture. Okay, so you have to do this particular homework today, and in the next lecture I'll be asking some questions on this homework. So that's it for today. I think we'll stop here.